So the topic given to me here is how to get your research published. What is the importance of this topic? Why is it so relevant? Research generates new knowledge that can change the way we understand the world and improve our quality of life. This knowledge, unless documented and published, is waste both in terms of manpower and money. So the objectives of my presentation is to make you all aware about the importance of the publication, how to write a paper, how to select a journal, difference between predatory and legitimate journal, and how to submit the research paper. So before I start, the previous days you came to know that a research start with a research question. You should have a good research question to start the research. After that, with the help of a biostatistician, you calculate sample size. Why do you calculate sample size? Because you can't do a study on a single person. No, you can recruit the whole patient population for the study. So you need to calculate the sample size. After that, you get approval from the research and ethics committee, and then later you perform the study. After that, what you do? You get a result. What do you do with that result? You're going to keep it with you? No, right? You need to communicate. By the way, what are the different ways of communication? It's verbal communication, non-verbal communication, and visual communication. Verbal communication is your oral and written communication. Non-verbal communication is, you know, your namaste or the signs you show. And then visual communication is the signboards which you see on the roads, like turn left. They don't write turn left. They just show the arrow, turn left. So in signs, what are the different ways of communication? How will you communicate signs? Verbally, definitely, verbal communication, definitely you use oral presentation and poster presentation. Written communication, you have paper publication, thesis publication, etc. Do you have non-verbal communication in science? No. Then, do you have visual communications in science? Yes. Your figures, your tables, your schematic diagrams are all visual communication. So again, though presenting or, you know, communicating your science work as oral presentation, poster presentation you can do, but written communication is given more weightage. And why is that so? Because it is documented. So thus comes a new term called scientific writing. What is scientific writing? Scientific writing is a way a scientist communicates his or her work to another scientist or experts. It is a technical writing by a scientist with an audience of peers. Peers means people who are expertise on that subject. For example, your thesis, article in journal like original article, case reports, etc. comes under scientific writing. So there is another term called science writing. What is science writing? Science writing is when you write for the general audience. Science writing is writing about science for the popular media. For example, the articles which comes in popular magazines or newspaper, these are all science writing. Any person who's interested in science can read it. But scientific writing, only peers can understand that. So again, why is it important? Why is scientific writing so important? Because it is a means of efficiently communicating scientific findings to the broad community of scientists in a uniform manner. This format allows the paper to be read at several different levels. If you remember, Dr. Govindanuni sir said that after reading the abstract, the reader will judge whether to read the paper or not. Okay, so that is why we write in scientific manner. So there are different types of journal articles in a journal. That is original research article, brief research communication, case reports, case series, review articles, letter to editor, viewpoint, commentaries, etc. So you can communicate your work in journal in all these type in these ways. Like if it's an original research, you can publish your paper as original research article. If it's a pilot study or something like that, you can communicate as brief research communication. And if you find any peculiar case or some interesting or novel case, you can report as case reports. And case series are more than 3 cases. And review articles. See, in a good journal, review articles are mostly invited. The editor invites the review articles. That doesn't mean that you can't write review articles. You can write, but the review article deals with, see the current situation or, you know, if the author knows that the author will collect a few journals, a few papers of some period, and then they give the summary of the event happening in that area of this of that particular time period. That is review article. Mostly expertise can write a review article. Anyone can write, but again review articles are always invited. Then you have a letter to editor and review points. The recent letter to editor which I found it very interesting is an article by our principal sir. It was the suicide, a celebrity suicide, a cause of medical media celebration, analysis of three newspaper reports. See, this paper deals with analysis of three newspaper reports about the death of a famous Bollywood star. So you can even write a paper, you can communicate in letter to editor also. But again, now comes, in MCA regulation, according to MCA regulation, you have career growth only if you have an original article, or if you publish as a case series or review article. So this in this session, I will be telling you about how to write an original article. Many of the things will be repetitive because Govindanuni sir has already told few things, but just for the sake of continuity, I am going to tell you what are the different steps in original article. So an original article contains title, author's name and affiliation, author for correspondence, abstracts, keywords, introduction, materials and method, results, discussion and conclusion, acknowledgement and references. So a title in an original article should be informative and relevant. It should preferably be one sentence or phrase, and abbreviation should not be used. But some of the abbreviation like DNA analyzer can be used. You don't write isolation of deoxyribonucleic acid. We generally write isolation of DNA. A title should be informative, yet create curiosity among the reader. It must contain hypothesis or problem. For example, tepid sponging or antipyretic for fever. It may contain a study population, tepid sponging or antipyretic for fever in children. It is good if you include research design also. So tepid sponging or antipyretic for fever in children, a randomized controlled trial. Next is author's name and affiliation. See, who are authors? Authors are who have substantially contributed to the study. For example, the person who has given you the idea or concept for the study. The second, the person who has collected data, analyzed it, and analyzed the result and interpreted the result properly. A person who has drafted the report. A person who has critically analyzed and drafted or rewritten the paper so that the paper is publishable. These are the criteria of being an author. And affiliation. Affiliation is where you work. You don't give your address. That is address of the place you have worked, not the place, not your residential address. So that is very, very important. Affiliation should be given here, the place where you are working. Then comes abstract. What is an abstract? An abstract is a short, self-contained, powerful summary of a research article. Generally, the length will be between 150 to 250 words. And layout, it will be either single paragraph or structure. Structure will be will contain background, methods, results, and conclusion. A reader can decide whether or not to read the whole article on. That is what Govindanuni sir said. After reading the abstract, he or she will decide whether to read the whole article or not. Then together, the title and the abstract should stand on its own. Then this is the example of a structured abstract. It has summary, that is background, methods, findings, interpretation. And this is the example of an unstructured abstract. It's a paragraph. Next comes keywords. Keywords are the most pertinent informative words pertaining to the research done. Keywords are for indexing, and possible readers can easily screen the content of the publication. See, then the previous example, if you see, the title is The Online Brain, How the Internet May Be Changing Our Cognition. Keywords are, I hope you can read, internet, cognition, attention, internet cognition is coming in title itself. Then others are attention, memory, social structures, social media, addiction, and virtual reality. See, you need to be intelligent enough to write those keywords so that your paper gets maximum view, or your paper gets when a reader types the keywords, your paper should come when the possible readers type the keywords, your paper should be visible. So introduction, next is introduction. Introduction, what do you write? You write what is already known, then lacunae of the study, which means a gap area, then objectives. An introduction should be informative, bring the readers up to date on what has already been done, provide background information on the research subject, explain the rationale of the study and your major objectives, state the hypothesis you are investigating, or define the problem you are trying to solve. See, aim and objectives. See, this part is not in, you don't write in a paper as a different section. I have given here just to make you understand what is the difference between aim and objectives. See, we don't write aims and objectives. It is aim and objectives. Aim is broad and objective is specific. Aim is what would be achieved by this study, or how the study would address a bigger question or issue. Objectives is specific. What would you actually do in this study? And as Joe Thomas said, objectives should be SMART. It should be specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. Then next comes materials and method. This is the most important section of your paper. See, a reviewer will judge your paper by reading this. You should be very, very clear that each about your materials use, the methods use. You have to be pakka and write clearly. The methodology should mention the study design and settings, sample size, duration of the study, that is how long did you take, that is 2 months or 3 months or 2 years or 3 years, whatever. Methods of recruitment of the sample or the patients, inclusion and exclusion criteria. Now in inclusion and exclusion criteria, you when you write inclusion criteria, as you have included patients from the age 25 to 60, you don't write an exclusion criteria that patients below 25 and above 60 were excluded from the study. It is already understood. It is already written there in our inclusion criteria. You have to write those factors which made you exclude those patients from the study. Like, for example, if the patient is under any medication, or if the patient has gone under any surgery, or even the patient is not ready to give consent. That also can be included in the exclusion criteria. Okay, and next is type of intervention, if any, method of follow-up and tools used for assessment. Standardization of method and reference to methodology should be given wherever necessary. So if you're doing a methodology which is already standard, you need not write each and every step. You just need to write the reference. But if you're standardizing that method, you have to give each and every method properly so that the reader can reproduce that experiment or the study. And then is machine specification. You have to specify the machine used, and statistical method used. Specify the software used. Okay. So next is results. In results, you present result in a logical and orderly fashion and use the same sequence as in materials and method section you have used. See, if you have given any primary objective, please give the result of primary objective first and then go on. Be complete but concise. This means that if you're writing a result, you got a result, you write it and you give in tabular formula, a tabular form, and then pie diagram, and then graph, it is not required. Give either in a table or graph or pie diagram. Make maximum use of tables and figures. One good graph can be worth of 1,000 words. If the data is important, present in table form tables. If you want to show the trends, show in graphs. Give final and meaningful data only. No raw data should be given. That is after statistical process. Then comes discussion section. What do all these results mean? See, in discussion, you don't write the results again. You have to write what does these results mean. Summarize the most important finding at the beginning. comment on the importance of the finding for practice, policy, and research. Relate the findings to those obtained by other researchers, whether they corroborate the result or whether they don't. Then comes conclusion. See, in conclusion, you write the significance of the work. Conclusion, in conclusion, it is, you know, you write, it is some kind of summary without being a summary. You have to write limitation of the study and you have to be honest at that. Some outlook of the usage, some speculation, and if there is any further research to be done. Then comes acknowledgement. Keep acknowledgements brief. Name those who helped you with your research, that is contributors or suppliers who provided free materials. Disclose any financial support or conflicting interest. Financial support, for example, if you have ICMR, STS funding, please write that in that acknowledgement. Then, this is a reference part. Include a reference which you have accessed and read. Give a list of related literature and information source. And there are different types of reference type, that is MLA, APA, Chicago, Harvard, and Vancouver. Generally, we use Vancouver style. Each and every journal specifies their own style of reference, but generally Vancouver is used and Harvard is also used. So in Harvard reference type, it uses the author's name and date of publication in the body of text, and bibliography is given in alphabetical order by author. This is the example Harvard reference type. In introduction, you can see the author's name and date of publication, the year of publication is given. This is Vancouver reference type. In this, it uses a number series to indicate references. Bibliographies list these in numerical order as they appear in the text. This is the example of Vancouver reference type. See, how to cite a reference. When you search for a reference, I mean, when you search for a paper, it might already be there. It might be there in the PubMed itself. How to cite the arrow? This arrow shows that how to cite. If you click this, you'll come to see here. The arrow shows. Just click this. You will get the style of references. And sometimes it will be given in the paper itself. Or else if you don't find anywhere, just write the paper, the name of the paper in Google Scholar and click there. You'll get this page. And then just click this inverted comma. You will get different types or styles of writing the reference. MLA, APA, Chicago, Harvard, and Vancouver. You can just select this and write it in your reference. Okay, now what is this? This is the citation. This is the number of times this paper has been cited by the authors. See, it is a paper on coronavirus. It's a recent one and has been published in March, I guess. And this has been cited by 729 people already. So after writing a paper, the major unethical practices which you see is plagiarism. What is plagiarism? Taking writing or ideas of another and representing as your own. Please don't do that. Fabricating, making up stories, that is cooking up stories, making up data or results and recording or reporting them. Falsification, manipulating research material or equipment, etc., or changing or omitting data or results. See, just to make the result significant, please don't place the decimal point somewhere else and tell that it is significant. Your result is your result, whether positive or negative. Please don't manipulate your result. Next come English. See, we are all not English, native English speakers, but still we have to follow a few rules. Don't show your English vocabulary in writing science. It should be simple, understandable, readable, and there should be a flow while reading a paper. And there are a few mistakes which we do, like we delete the redundant words like true and accurate, full and complete, final outcome, etc. And the English language we use, we say IV was given. We don't give IV fluid. We administrate IV fluid. The results were found to be, you don't find something. When you lose something, you find it. The results were observed or obtained. So the English should be given more important, but don't show your vocabulary skills there. Just be simple and, you know, read a lot of paper. You will come to know how to write a better English. Then final step is revision and proofreading. After writing the first draft, at least a dozen of revision are required, needed to improve the text. Make sure that all authors read the first draft, give timeline, and then revise and revise and revise. And if possible, give that paper to a person who's in the same department who can understand that work, but they have not involved in that work. Then you will come to know if there is any, if there is any flow or whether it is readable or not. Next is article submission. Select your journal carefully. So if you remember, Ashokan sir said that, you need an ethics approval or ethics certificate to publish in a good journal. What do you mean by good journal? What is the purpose of a journal, by the way? A journal the journal's purpose is to publish the recent development of the science or of that particular subject. And who does that? The editor first will read the paper and will decide whether the article or the paper is of that standard. And then it will be passed to the reviewers. The reviewers later will read, critically analyze the paper, and then allow to get published in that paper. So this is how the journal works. But there are few new journals which doesn't work like that. So that is how a new term called predatory journal was evolved. It was coined by Dr. Jeffrey Bell, and he's a librarian. And according to him, a predatory journal is publisher or journals whose sole concern is to collect money and provide rapid publishing without peer review. Jeffrey Bell, he is the one who initiated and he maintains a list of predatory journals and publishers. You can see Bell's, it's called Bell's List. You can Google it. You can find the list of predatory journals according to him. It is extremely damaging to the scientific record. They don't appear to provide typical publishing services such as quality control, licensing, and indexing. So why is it so important to talk about predatory journals? Because many researchers and potential authors are not aware of the problem of predatory journal. See, a legitimate journal, to get published in a legitimate journal, it takes time because the editor will read it and then the reviewer will critically read and analyze the paper. It takes time for that. But in predatory journal, this is quick publication, which people think that anyways, it is getting published, will publish in predatory journal. They're not aware of the problem. May not be able to detect a predatory journal or distinguish from the legitimate journal. So what is the problem? Impact on the researchers and research community as a whole if you publish in predatory journal. There is no academic gain. Academic reputation is at stake. Disregarded sound research, waste of your research funding. It hurts the career and there is no visibility. What do you mean by visibility? See, when you write a paper, you want others to read it and refer it in their paper. So, see, this is an example of Indian Journal of Cancer. Here it's written in reference part, pseudo journals or predatory journals should not be quoted in the references. As a rule of thumb, choose journals which is published in Medline or Scopus or Web of Science. So your paper or your work gets wasted if it is published in a predatory journal. See, as I told you, some of them can't distinguish predatory journal and legitimate journal. That is because some of the time it will be, the predatory journal has names which are similar to the existing journal. That is legitimate journal, for example, there is a journal called Preventive Medicine. And this is a predatory journal, it is called Journal of Preventive Medicine. A legitimate journal is International Journal of Public Health, whereas predatory journal, the name is International Journal of Environmental Research and Public Health. Archies of Internal Medicine, Archies of Medicine. So like that, there is a similarity in name. People get confused. Their authors or the potential researchers get confused whether it's a predatory journal or a legitimate journal. So what are the salient features of a potential predatory journal? the scope. If you read, you need to research on a journal. When you start thinking of publishing a paper in a particular journal, you need to do a good research of the journal also. See, the scope of the interest includes non-biomedical subjects along with biomedical topics. The website contains spelling and grammar errors. Images are distorted or fuzzy, intended to look like something they are not, or which are unauthorized. The homepage language targets author. See, in a legitimate journal, the homepage language will be actually targeted to the readers, not the authors. It will show what are the upcoming articles to get published. Whereas in this predatory journal, it is targeting the authors. It will get full easily published. It is indexed in that, and it is it has impact factor of something. There's no impact factor, but still they write it's in the impact factor is 3.4, something like that. And the index Copernicus values promoted on the website. A description of the manuscript handling process is lacking. Manuscripts are requested to be submitted via email. Generally, you need to register, and then I will show you how to submit a paper. I'll show it in a couple of minutes. Then rapid publication is promised. There is no retraction policy. Information on whether or how the journal content will be digitally preserved is absent. The article processing charge is very low. The contact email address is non-professional and non-journal affiliated. That is, for example, @gmail.com or @yahoo.com. So this is the example of a typical predatory journal. It says European Journal of Biomedical and Pharmaceutical Science. And if you see the publisher, it is in Bhandara, Maharashtra. I've been to Bhandara. I've not seen any Europe there. And this is another typical, predatory journal. And see, look at the look itself says it's not a good journal. And again, there is an impact factor. They say it's impact factor PIF. 2017 is 3.95. See, the impact factor which a good or a legitimate journal follows is JCR impact factor. And it is maintained by a company called Clarivate Analytics. This impact factor, I don't know what does this mean, but this is not the impact factor which we follow. And they have written many things like, so this is for the author, targeted to the authors. It is written Medical Council of India, validated publication, then what else? It is indexed in Index Medicus, Index Copernicus, and it's available in both printed and online version, and so many things. And an international indexed monthly online and printed peer-reviewed journal. And here we are. So look at the look itself shows that this journal is a predatory journal. It doesn't look beautiful at all. Fine. Then after you write the whole paper, as I said, select your journal carefully. Then after you select the journal, read the aim and scope of the journal. Think about your target audience and level of your work. Do you have a realistic chance of being accepted? See, it's good to aim a good journal, but again, you should be realistic whether it will get published in that paper or accepted in that journal or not. So you need to be realistic. Follow the guidelines in the notes of authors and include everything that they have asked. It makes the editor's job easier. Otherwise, editor will reject the paper because you have to follow the guidelines which has given in the author section. Articles should not be submitted in more than one journal at a time. So this is very important. Some of them come and ask, can we submit our paper in different journal, 2-3 journal at a time, so that if it gets published in that journal, we can retrieve from that another journals. You are not supposed to do that. It is unethical. Okay, now topics so far, I hope it is everything is clear to you. Okay, now the topics covered so far are about the importance of the publication, how to write a paper, how to select a journal, difference between predatory and legitimate journal. And now I will show you how to submit the research paper. It will be a live class, I hope. Thank you. Connection. പി പി ടി അത്രേ ഉള്ളൂ. ഞാൻ ഇനിയിപ്പോ അവരെ കാണിക്കാനാണ്. ഞാൻ Okay. So I am taking a journal, Indian Journal of Medical Research. It's a journal by ICMR. So if I have a paper and I wish to publish in this journal, first I have to read the whole journal properly. So this is the home of the journal. Then the more kaun aata hai? Nice.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the home of the journal. You have to read each and every point carefully. You have to do research on the journal also. So this is the. Abra. Agree. Acha ida. Okay. Now this is. They have written about abstracting and indexing. The journal is registered with the following abstracting partners, and you can read the abstracting where this journal is indexed or not. It is indexed in Medlines, Corpus, etc. And the impact factor. Look at this impact factor as reported in 2019 Journal Citation Reports. That is JCR, Clarivate Analytics 2020. It is 1.503. So this is the impact factor which we talk about, a legitimate journal talk about. So after that, this is the home page of the journal. Now we have to read about us. What's there about the journal? It says about the journal, and then abstracting and indexing again, journal ethics. Scope of the journal. So here it's given the scope of the journal. The journal publishes original communication of biomedical research that advances or illuminates medical sciences or that educates the journal readers. Articles with clinical interest and implication will be given more preference. So this is how the scope of the journal is all about. So you have to read that also. And then comes the issues. How many issues do they have?
Archives.
Yeah, archives. You can go through archives also. The IJMR is published monthly in 2 volumes and 12 issues per year. Again, if you can't read all these, if you don't have time, you can go to archives and then just see how many issues are there per year. They have 2 volumes per year, and they have 12 issues per year. That is what it's written, and that's what I'm showing you. Now, before submitting your article, you need to read the instructions of the journal properly. So this is the instruction to the authors. Read each and every point clearly so that it is easier for the editor to understand the paper, or else it will get directly rejected. They won't even read it, because if you don't waste time or give any importance of that journal, then they will not read that paper. So read each and every point clearly and make a submission after that. The each journal has its own style to write a paper. See, in this, it says that the original article should be preferably 2,500 to 3,500 words. But that doesn't mean that you have to write till 2,500 words. You can be simple, concise, and communicate it in a very simple way. This means the maximum word limit is 2,500 to 3,000 words, excluding the abstract and references. And it should contain structured abstract. Now, in this journal, they want the abstract to be structured, which has the word limit of 250. and under subheadings, background and objectives, methods, results and interpretation and conclusions, followed by 5 to 8 keywords arranged alphabetically. Some journals ask you to arrange the keywords alphabetically. You have to read each and every point properly. Then the main article should include sections of following order, that is introduction, materials and method, results, discussion, acknowledgement if any, conflict of interest and references. And see, sometimes even they ask for ethics committee certificate. So you should be having that also. That is what Ashokan sir said. Then you have reviews and others and others. You need to read each and every section properly. Whichever paper you are submitting, you have to read it properly and make changes and then submit it online. So how do you submit online? You generally register to that journal. To submit your paper online, you need to articles can be submitted electronically from here. Registration is available here. If you are a new author, please register as a new register. I've already registered it, so I have my own username and ID. My role is an author, as an author. Login. Gudula.vallur@gmail.com. Number lock off. Okay, fine. I'm wired to come. Principal, sir.
I
anyways, leave it. So after you register your name, and then you get a username and your password, you'll get into the journal, and then you can submit a paper as it is, as they give the instruction. You have to just follow the instruction as they have said. So that's what I wanted to tell you, to how to submit a paper. I hope it's clear. So by this time, you got to know how to do a research, how to communicate a research properly, and how to publish in a good journal. That's it. Thank you so much. If you have any doubts, please ask.
Hi, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, there are some doubts in the chat box.
Yeah. Okay. Ma'am, can you... Okay. You may post. Okay. Very informative session, hearing a lot of points from the first time. Ma'am, what exactly is machine specification? What do we write under the that heading? See, machine specification is that, see, every machine has its own make and year of production. So you have to write that. That's what you write in machine specification. You have to be you have to write the make of the machine and year of for example, if you're using a blood analyzer, you need to specify the machine properly. Ma'am, how is reference different from plagiarism? Reference different from plagiarism? Reference is I didn't get your question. See, plagiarism is when you are cut, copy, and paste that paper. Reference is you're referring that paper to know what is written in that paper. That is, if the paper has something to do with your work, you refer it so that you get a knowledge about it. Plagiarism is completely copying that paper like that, or the concept completely like that. That is what plagiarism means. I think I have cleared that. Soumya Johnson. Okay, anyways, ma'am, is there any time limit within which article has to be published? No, it's up to you. I mean, if at all you want your paper to be published fast. But again, see, if you are publishing in a legitimate journal, it will take time. You know, the editor will first see, as I told you, editor will first see, and then the reviewers will critically analyze that paper. But if that paper is something to do with novel, and that's like COVID and corona types, definitely they will publish it fast. But again, they will critically analyze the paper, then only they will publish it. And there is no time limit for getting your paper published. It's up to you, not to the nothing to do with us. Ma'am, can you suggest the few best statistical analysis software for beginners? See, that you have to ask biostatistician. I am very poor in biostatistics. I can't help you in that. I'm really sorry. Is it Mrudula right? Username is wrong. Ma'am, do check the username again. Okay. I'm really sorry. I mean, I had actually, registered today morning so that I can show you live demo how to submit a paper. It all went wrong. Okay. After submission of an article to a journal, when can we expect to know if our journal is accepted or not? See, it depends upon journal to journal. Again, you have to see the acceptance rate. You see, if the editor is, if your paper is very much not up to the mark, the editor will give you the result within a day or so, or 2 days. But if the editor has given the paper to the reviewers, it might take time, and it depends upon the journal to journal. You have to see the archives. Again, you have to see the volume, see when the paper was submitted and how long it took to get published. So, select the journal likewise. Ma'am, will quoting definition by renowned associations like WHO account for plagiarism? No. And you can, you're quoting the definition. It is not plagiarism, and then you're giving the reference to that, so it is not plagiarism. If one journal rejects our article, can we submit to any other journal? Why not? Good question. Anyways, yes, if the paper is rejected in one journal, you can modify that same paper and submit it in another journal, because after all, you want your work to be published. Ma'am, what is meant by standardization of method? Also, if an article is rejected from a journal, can we apply for it again after editing? Yes, see, yes. Standardization of a method. So if you have, for example, I am a plant biotechnologist. So see, if you have standardized a method for DNA isolation from plant, standardization means, you know, you change few factors so that you can isolate the DNA properly. Like, you know, maintaining the temperature or changing the temperature. This is called standardized. There's a process for isolating DNA step by step. You standardize in one particular step. So that is standardization of method. And if you have standardized that method, you generally see that method is used for isolation of DNA from plant material. But if you have standardized, you have to write the, you know, the materials and at the methods clearly. I hope it is understood. And if also if an article is rejected from the journal, can we apply for it again after editing? After editing, I don't think so, because they have already read the paper and they have rejected the article just because it is not of the standard of the journal. So they won't accept it even if you edit it, I guess. No, but you can definitely submit in another journal. Ma'am, does the order of authors have importance? Okay, good question. The thing is, according to MCI, now preference is given to first three authors and corresponding authors. Again, I forgot to talk about corresponding authors. Who are corresponding authors? Corresponding authors are not those who do the secretarial work. Corresponding authors are those authors who can answer the reviewers' queries. Those are called corresponding authors. So again, the order of the authors are important. See, according to the life science, corresponding authors always the, you know, it's given more weightage, because the person who's given the concept and he can answer the queries of the reviewers are called corresponding authors. And again, first authors are those who have done the work. So order of the authors, yes, as such, first three authors, according to MCI, first three authors and corresponding authors are given importance. Ma'am, suppose we take a relevant statement from a paper as much, but by giving reference to it in a paper, so would that be a plagiarism as well? See, why are you giving that statement? You are referring a paper for your reference. You need not write the same thing what they have told. You can write in a different way again, but then at least, you know, you're not supposed, yes, then you can give the references, not that simply you take it similarly and you change the statement
again. Yes, you have to, you know, you can't just say, write the same thing. You need to change the statement and write, and then if you refer also, it's not an issue. Ma'am, can you please tell how reference manager works, like Zotero? I forgot to talk about Zotero and Mendeley. Yes, these are reference manager, and one practical section of the same if possible. Okay, I'll see to that, because even we have to ask for it, because Mendeley we have not downloaded. I'll see to that and let you know, at least not now, sometimes later. What could you elaborate on impact factor? What is that? See, impact factor of a journal means the impact of that journal to the readers. The number of times it has been referred, a single article has been referred in that particular year. That is the impact factor of that journal. And as I said, JCR, the Clarivate Analysis Company maintains the impact factor of that journal, of a journal. Okay, and ma'am, if the references are very less or my research is novel or new, will it be a problem? Already got rejected from ICMOSTs. Ma'am, if the references are very less or my research is novel or new, will it be a problem? See, references are very less, means anyways you have got an idea from somewhere, right? You need to refer that. So how small is that references? I mean, how many references have you got? Only at least less than 10 you might have got, right? That is also pretty, you know, some journals accepts paper with very less references also. Ma'am, could you give some example of journals in which other medical students of UG level can publish in the have published in the past? See, any journals, as our principal sir said, any journals you can be published in UG level students also. It's nothing to do with the education. It's about the research you have done. If that research is good, you will get published in a good journal. Ma'am, if our journal is rejected by a journal, how do we know there is reason for it? They will give the reason for it. If the editor is there, they will say it's not you know, up to the mark of the journal, or else the reviewer will give the exact, if you are giving it to the good journal, the reviewer will give you a good reason of rejecting that paper in that journal. Ma'am, what exactly is conflict of interest? See, conflict of interest is okay, I'll refer, because it is very difficult to make you understand what is conflict of interest. See, conflict of interest is a set of condition in which professional judgment. Can you hear me? Am I audible? I can't hear.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you are audible. Yes.
Okay, conflict of interest is a set of condition in which professional judgment conceiving a primary interest such as patient's welfare or the validity of research tends to be unduly influenced by a secondary interest. Such as, see, if you have, you know, if you're being funded by a pharmacy company, your result shouldn't be, you know, your result shouldn't be conflict of interest with that. That is conflict of interest. Hello. I am, see, the thing is,
if a research team member belongs related to that pharma company,
The result should not be influenced by that pharma company. That is called conflict of interest. I hope it's clear. Ma'am, suppose I'm developing an altogether new methodology for research paper instead of whatever available now, will it be acceptable or should it be presented or accepted for acceptance? I didn't get your question. Ma'am, suppose I'm developing an altogether new methodology for research paper instead of whatever available now, will it be acceptable, accepted, or should it be presented for acceptance? See, if it's a new methodology, you should do a pilot study, and then it might get be then, you know, it may get accepted. According to feasibility, it might get accepted. There's nothing wrong in, you know, doing new methodology altogether. Okay, that's it. Okay, that's the question. All the best. I hope it's clear.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.